Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another broadcast of Wealth and Wisdom with Fred Belcastro from the John DeVito Broadcast Center on the Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network and Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM Norwich on Friday, November the 4th, the year 2016. And now here he is, live and in person, Mr. Fred Belcastro.
And the whole world smiles with you. And when you're laughing, oh, you're laughing. When the sun comes shining through. When you're crying, you bring on the rain. Stop your sighing. Won't you be happy again? When you're smiling, keep on smiling. And the world will smile.
Good morning and welcome to the Wealth and Wisdom program. My name is Fred Belcastro, your host. And during the next 30 minutes, we're going to talk about using wisdom, our wisdom to grow and protect our wealth. And as usual, we're fortunate to be broadcasting from the John DeVito Broadcast Center here on the northwest side of Chicago. And yes, this Friday morning, you are listening to us on Jack FM 89.7 WRHS in Norridge, Illinois. Well, this morning we have a couple of tunes, you might remember the Silhouettes back from the 50s. And of course, we have a tune by Chicago's own Mr. Gene Chandler. We're going to play a little bit later. The young folks I hear speak today when making plans for something to go on a little bit later in the week or in the day, they'd say, sounds like a plan, sounds like a plan. And I think, here they are, they're making plans, and I don't know if it means exactly the same as the plans I talk about, but it's evident, we all can agree, that to accomplish anything, we have to have a plan. You have to have a plan to go to work. You have to plan to take care of your occupation. We take our plan to go down Harlem Avenue. We make a left, a right on Irving Park Road. But nevertheless, we have a plan. And we have a plan that's usually a well-thought-out strategy to make it happen. Well, the same goes with our finances. You know, it doesn't make any sense at all, no sense at all, to accumulate assets, to have a pot full of money, and then not protect it. We don't put our pots. I see pumpkins out on the street today. I don't see pots of money. See, our money is something that we want to keep safe. We want to protect our money, and yet we don't administer any plans to do that. Understand that what I've talked about in the years and years I've been on the radio is that if you have something and it can be taken away by someone or some event, it's not really yours. What sense is it to accumulate a fortune during our working years only to have it taken away because we fail to protect it? What I do is really to help you keep what you've worked so hard to achieve. That's not tough. It's not a hard... not a hard thing. It might be a very meaningful statement. It might be something we don't like to give thoughts to. But my philosophy is that there's more of an opportunity for us to serve my clients by helping them avoid the potential losses or the real losses that they face. What makes what I do, I think, unique is that I help the clients find the money. Find the money that you're losing. Find the money that you're losing unknowingly and unnecessarily. Unnecessarily is the big point here. Find it, keep it, bring it back to the table, and then use it. Use it in one of a couple of different ways. And I've talked about for years what good is the money. It has to be liquid. You have to have control over the money. If you don't have the liquidity, use and control of your money, it's not really your money. So the first thing I do is solidify protection. Protect the money. You need to secure your lifestyle. You got a pot of gold here. You got a, is that what you call your nest egg? All right, you've got a nest egg. you got a big pot of gold. You just don't leave it there, on a dining room table for someone to walk in and take it. I think, okay, the second thing that you've got to do is use that money. Use those found dollars, the found dollars, to your saving investments. Add them to your savings account. Add them to your investment account. When you go and transfer dollars, when you transfer wealth in the form of interest expense and financial costs and all of those that I've listed in the past, when you transfer these dollars, whether knowingly or unknowingly, you're giving away a chunk of your money. Not only that, but they're economically, we're looking at opportunity costs on top of that that should be added. So this total welfare, this whole total transfer of dollars, bring it back. You keep it. You put it in your savings and investment account. I don't care. I'm not here to say you've got to invest it in an annuity. You've got to invest it in mutual funds. You've got to buy stocks. You've got to do, you've got to listen. How practical. I'm telling you to save your money. Don't throw it away. Don't run up charge accounts. Don't have revolving accounts. Don't have anything like that that's going to transfer these dollars away. You need those dollars. You need them, first of all, to conserve your dollars to secure your retirement and your current lifestyle at some point. And, of course, the third thing is you'd like to use some of those dollars to provide for a cash flow. One of the biggest planning events that I do is for individuals 50, 55, and beyond is the cash flow. Very important. At various ages, as retirement sets in, there is a chance of outliving your nest egg or your dollars. These are big concerns. So I think, again, bringing it back to the uniqueness of my practice, working to help accomplish all these three things. And here's the biggest point that I want to make. Get it through your head and understand that these dollars that we're accomplishing, that we're gaining, are dollars you're currently losing. You don't have to take away from any of your current lifestyle. You don't have to reduce your current lifestyle today or tomorrow to do these things. These are applications of your dollars that you're throwing away. Save them. You know, people use very sophisticated plans and place to pay for their lifestyle during retirement. It's a big, big area of planning, lifestyle planning and into retirement. We're retirement planning specialists. Or you hear these things. You see these ads and these advertisements and these individuals touting the retirement planning as the masters of 401, masters of IRAs, and this is what you should and shouldn't do with your money. The plans, everybody designs plans that would create an income stream that would pay everyday living expenses for you. But who's talking about one of the biggest expenses that you have? Why is it that study after study after study talk about the result at age, whatever it is that we leave leave this earth, that we leave it almost dead broke? That there was a study that I reported on just a few weeks ago that said that the average amount of dollars, the average nest egg, to most individuals at the conclusion of their life, is something that around $10,000. Very minute amount of dollars. Most of the dollars had gone not only to provide living expenses, but unfortunately lacking to consider one significant expense, and that's the expense of the cost of our care, of long-term care. You know, with all the retirement planning options that are available today, it's important that you remember one thing, everybody. People need enough income to cover your expenses. And long-term care is one of the services that can be one of the largest eroding factors of our dollars, of your nest egg. People want to retire and have their income last as long as possible. It's never run out of money. People are concerned about their retirement income running out and having to rely on maybe Medicaid if you don't have other coverage. You know, for Medicaid will provide for your long-term needs, nursing homes of such. How about couples? Couples have different care needs. One or the other may need care, or both of them. Let me just give you some facts, according to the Department of Health and Human Services. You ready? According to the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, 70% of people who reach age 65 will need long-term care at some point in their lives. 70%. Is that 7 out of 10? Can we look at it that way? 7 out of 10 people? You know what I did some time ago? I went outside to count the houses on the block. All right? 10 houses, 15, 20 houses? You mean 14%, 14 of those houses out of 20 are going to have some long-term care expenses? That's going to be devastating. And it's not, you don't just pay them with Halloween candy either. These long-term care services are very expensive. Based on the national average costs, get ready to pay $233 a day for a semi-private room in a nursing home. $233 a day plus adding up to more than $70,000 to $85,000 a year. Now, you have a pot of gold. You feel pretty good about that money you have on the dining room table. You look at your checking account. Look at your 401k's statements every month and feel pretty secure with that. How about if we took a chunk of $75,000, $80,000 a year out of that to pay for nursing home expenses? Now, the spouse you leave at home while you're in the nursing home eating up the chunks of $70,000 out of your pot of gold, how are they going to survive? How do you think that affects their mental capacity? $4,200 a month for a one-bedroom unit in an assisted living facility. That's $4,000 a month. That's $1,000 a week. Just for the one-bedroom. $22 an hour for the services of a home health aide. $61 an hour for a licensed practical nurse, an LPN. Take care of you at home. How do you pay for it? Have you ever thought about how you're going to pay for it? Hey, listen, we don't have to worry. Listen, I've heard so many times these individuals. First of all, if I might say, I've heard so many individuals say that we're number one. They never played baseball, basketball, football in their lives, and yet they're claiming to be one of the winners. I don't know. But nevertheless, you've heard these individuals say, yeah, listen, when something happens to me, I don't care what they do to me. Tell the little woman that who's wringing her hands in sweat and tears when something happens to their husbands, not knowing how they're going to pay for it or what they're going to do next. I'm called in on cases where I see the widows distraught, not knowing which way to turn because nothing has been planned for it. And yet we talk over and over and over about planning for these necessities. It's going to happen just like the train on the railroad track, just like I've talked for years about retirement. If you're fortunate enough to live a long life, you're going to reach retirement at some point, and you're going to be faced with some of these expenses. There isn't anybody over 65, 70 years old that doesn't say to me, Fred, each day I find a new ill. Each day I find a new pain, a new little discomfort, and I better go to the doctor. I better check on this, better check on that. I better get a test for this, a test. Well, who pays for all this? You know, the government? Are we going to use the Medicare the privileges of the limited coverages that's designed by the government? And you see what happens when government takes control of our medicine. We can see that what's happened to our poor servicemen who wait months and months for treatment at the various hospitals that they're allowed to go through. So do you think the government's going to provide for this utopian situation? How about we're going to pay for it ourselves? How long is it going to last? Take a look at your money and divide it up into the number of years and the number of years you're going to retire, maybe 25, 30 years that you have left after retirement. You're going to be able to pay $60,000, $70,000 a year and still have money left over to, hey, I'm going to leave the kid. Hey, they're taken care of. How many times have I heard individuals talk about, hey, that's my kids are taken care of. My kids got this. My kids got. I find out it's not true. That is unbelievable. Unbelievable. So let's quit lying to ourselves. Sometimes don't lie to our spouses. Maybe nothing's all right. If everything's okay, let's sit down and what's your plan, Charlie? What are we doing here? You see? Why don't I take a break and back off a little bit? Let's listen to the Silhouettes. All right.
Dip 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 dip. Sha-la-la-la, sha-la-la-la, puddle. Sha-la-la-la, sha-la-la-la, puddle. Sha-la-la-la, sha-la-la-la, puddle. Sha-la-la-la, sha-la-la-la, puddle. Dip 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 dip. Mm-mm-mm-mm-mm, get a job. Sha-la-la-la, sha-la-la-la,
puddle. You make me money to buy the stocks. You get me out of my bed of crying for the job.
Me.
I then go back to the house, hear that woman's mouth
reaching and crying, tell me that I'm lying about a job that I never could find. Sha-la-la-la, sha-la-la-la, puddle. Sha-la-la-la, sha-la-la-la, puddle. Sha-la-la-la, sha-la-la-la, puddle. Sha-la-la-la, sha-la-la-la, puddle.
Get a Job by the Silhouettes from 1957. Now, having listened to that music, having listened to that beat, do you still think you could dance the way you did in 1957 to that kind of music? My wife did. She was on the Jim Lonsberry Show. Some of you may remember that TV show in the 50s, Jim Lonsberry. They'd have the kids going up there from Chicagoland and dancing on TV at that time. She was one of those girls that wore those long poodle skirts and dancing. I don't think old Mare would dance quite the same today. Anyway, I know I couldn't. But getting back, and of course you knew I would, the long-term care insurance, we have the government paying for it, we have the self-funding, and we have some insurance companies paying for it as well. That runs into a lot of money. The cost of long-term care is one of the major retirement financial worries and concerns, I think, of most individuals. Let me stop and make mention of our phone number that we can be reached during the week. It's area 630-673-4360. That's 630-673-4360. And my email address is fbelsecure@aol.com. That's FBELSECURE@AOL.com. Sure, I think we're all aware of the major retirement concerns. I talked about the cash flow and running out of money. Survey after survey confirms that. The data also confirms that very few people are actually doing anything about their long-term care. I mean, one survey even found that a lot of people would rather go to the dentist than to talk to somebody about long-term care. You know, we talk about it. We talk about, yeah, that's a problem, but for many of us, too few give much thought to it. We should. Remember the wealth and wisdom? How smart are we if we don't make plans for this type of provision? If we put insurance and comprehensive on our automobiles out there, and you click the little clicker, does the alarm go on? The doors lock? Wow, we feel good about the protection. We lock our garage doors. We feel pretty good about that. How about our life, our own human life values? Should that be treated the same way? Maybe we should give some thought or consideration. You know, you don't have to be afraid to talk to somebody about long-term care. You could put together a plan to pay for it in case you need it. There's no magic. There's no magic bullet to the planning. Instead, get some goals. Set goals. Know what these costs can run you. And then consider all the tools available. Aha! Here's the part. Considering everything that's available, if we look at some of the transferred dollars, some of the needless expenses that we have today, perhaps some of those dollars can be put into an application of providing for some of these benefits that we're going to certainly face. Then maybe you have a plan in place that both meets your needs and something that's affordable. Remember, the long-term care is more than just going into a nursing home. No one's going to want to throw their partner into a nursing home. And for those that I've had the privilege of working with, some real gentlemen that you visited their spouse every day, and made sure that they ate and took care of it. It's an ordeal, let me tell you. And some of you already may know it. But long-term care can be a type of assistance with activities of daily living, just normal day in and day out things that we need to do to take care of ourselves. Maybe someone to come in once a day to clean up the house or to cook or provide some home health care or some therapy to us. You know, that's considered long-term care as well. You know, maybe to give the missus or one or the other of the individuals a bit of relief. Would it be nice to be able to leave the house for a couple of hours every day while someone else came in and helped with some of the duties so that you can get out, maybe go walk at the mall or enjoy the pleasant days of it that Indian summer gives us? Some sort of physical therapy for you as well as the individual. So there's more to it than just living in a nursing home and continuing care retirement community. If it's necessary, long-term care would take care of that as well. You know, but most people that I've run across want to stay in their own homes for as long as they can. But why don't we hear from Chicago's very own? This is an individual out of Englewood High School.
Doop 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 a bell, 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 doop 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 a bell, doop 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 a bell, doop 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 a bell, doop doop.
As I walk through this world, nothing can stop the doop of earth. And you are my girl, and no one can hurt you. Oh no, yes I Duchess of Earth. We'll walk through my dukedom and the paradise we will share. Yes, I.
A song that came out in 1961. I think Gene Chandler did it in 62 when he decided to put on a top hat, a cape, carry a cane, and in the style that only the Duke can do, presented himself on stage. Just a great performer and a great gentleman, Mr. Gene Chandler from Chicago, the Duke of Earl. Sure, I think nobody wants to get sick and go into a nursing home. They do want to stay. We want to live in our homes, but it becomes easier and easier each year. More and more long-term care coverage is given in residence. It might have to be by a professional, but yet more and more care is being able to be provided in our very own homes. And some people want or assume that when they need help, they can be assisted by family members. I can give you story after story after story about that. Sometimes it works out. Sometimes it really doesn't. And when it's one of those dozens, it's tragic. Other people would prefer a professional caregiver. Don't want to burden family members. Yet other people again don't want strangers in their home. It goes on and on. But you've got to decide for yourself, and be sure that. The preferences, be sure the decisions that you make are realistic. And then consider the options that are available. I think a lot of people understand that the majority of older people will need some care, some assistance at some point in their lives. But also, hey, it ain't going to be me. It won't be me that needs that care. I'm fine. So let's quit the... Let's quit fooling ourselves. Let's try to quit fooling others around us and look at the statistics and look at the possibilities of this coming home to roost. There are a lot of elements to be considered in long-term care planning. I myself had written many policies years ago when it was first brought to our attention that these things were available for those, and yet we've seen plans change. We've seen premium increases. You talk about Obamacare, the affordability care, premiums going up 20%, 30%, and 40%. That happened a lot in the industry with some of the long-term care. That's why today I use other provisions that I think are more advantageous to individuals. Rather than just buying a long-term care policy, we can do it by, what have I been saying? By planning, by using a little bit of wisdom, the knowing what's available, taking advantage of what's available without giving our money away, losing control. Remember, I was a big proponent of having the liquidity, use, and control of our money. Let's keep it that way while at the same time providing for not only ourselves, but really we're providing for our family members that would be forced to take care of us. All right, that's it for this week. We'll carry on our discussion perhaps next week. And in the meantime, let's take advantage of these beautiful days that we have. Help somebody, and let's put a smile on somebody's face. Thanks for listening. Talk to you again next week.
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
and the whole world smiles with you.
Smiles with you.
And when you're laughing,
when you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing,
oh,
when the sun comes shining through,
shining through.
When you're crying,
when you're crying,
you bring on the rain,
bring on the
stop
rain.
Your sighing,
stop your sighing.
Won't you be happy again?
Happy again.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
keep on smiling,
keep on smiling,
and the world will smile.
You have been listening to Wealth and Wisdom with Fred Belcastro from the John DeVita Broadcast Center on Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM Norwich and the Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network on Friday, November the 4th, the year 2016. This broadcast was directed by John DeVita. Our special thanks to radio station manager Kevin Zeflik of WRHS FM Norwich, and the executive producer of Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network, Mr. John Secondo. Until next time, please be safe and thanks for listening. This broadcast was pre-recorded on Wednesday, November the 2nd, the year 2016. Have a safe and enjoyable weekend, everyone. And this is Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM, Norwich, Illinois.